I will continue with Act 1, Scene 2. In the previous part, we already came to know that Portia is not at all happy with the lottery system devised by her father because it did not give her the freedom to choose her own husband, and at the same time, she could not refuse also anyone whom she did not like. So she is sad and upset, and here Nerissa is trying to console her and make her understand. Nerissa, your father was ever virtuous, and holy men at their death have good inspirations. So here Nerissa is saying that Portia's father was a virtuous person, a pious, a religious person with noble qualities, and holy men, that is good men, at their death have good inspirations, that is such good men, what they say before dying will result in something good if it is followed. Therefore the lottery that he had devised in these three chests of gold, silver and lead, whereof who chooses his, meaning chooses you, will no doubt never be chosen by any rightly, but one who shall rightly love. So Nerissa says that therefore the lottery system which Portia's father had devised, which contained three chests, that is three caskets of gold, silver and lead, and whoever chooses his meaning here means the right casket, chooses you, that is Portia. So the person who chooses the right casket chooses Portia. He will win Portia and marry her. Will no doubt never be chosen by any rightly. So there is no doubt that the right casket will be chosen by anyone. It can be chosen, but one who shall rightly love. But she had a feeling, a strong feeling, that it will be chosen, the right casket will be chosen by a person who truly loved Portia. Rightly here means truly. So she had a strong belief that the right casket will be chosen by someone who truly loves Portia. But what warmth is there in your affection towards any of these princely suitors that are already come? And then Nerissa, just to change the topic, she asks Portia that what warmth is there in your affection? That is, does Portia have any special affection towards any of the princely suitors? Princely suitors means towards any of the princes who had come as suitors in order to marry Portia. Portia, I pray thee overname them, and as thou namest them, I will describe them. So Portia says that, tells Nerissa that you overname them. Overname means you call out, you say their names, and as she tells the names, as Nerissa tells the names one by one, Portia will describe them. And according to my description, level at my affection. And then when Nerissa names the suitors one by one, then Portia will describe them. And according to her description, then Nerissa can decide whether she likes that person or not. Here, level at my affection means decide. Nerissa can decide whether Portia has any affection for that suitor or not. Nerissa, first there is the Neapolitan prince. So first Nerissa names the Neapolitan prince, that is the prince of Naples. Portia, aye, that's a colt indeed, for he doth nothing but talk of his horse. So here Portia says that that's a colt. He is a colt. He is like a colt, is a young horse. So she says that the Prince of Naples is like a young horse, that is an inexperienced young man. because he does nothing but only talks about his horse. All the time he was so interested in his horse that the Prince of Naples, all the time he used to talk only about his horse. And he makes it a great appropriation to his own good parts that he can shew himself. And this prince, he considered it a great proper act of his own ability that he could shew himself. Shew himself means to shew the horse, to nail the shoe at the on the hooves of the horse. So he considered it his good ability of his that he could shew his own horse. Nerissa, then is there the county palatine. Now Nerissa names the second suitor, who is the county palatine. County palatine means the count, that is the ruler of Palatine, a region, a place in Germany. Portia, he doth nothing but frown. Portia says that he does nothing but only frowns. He always has a frowning face. As who should say, and you will not have me choose. And according to her, it seemed as if he would say that if Portia, you will not have me, that is, he means to say that if Portia does not want him, then she can choose anyone else. That is, he doesn't bother, he doesn't care if Portia does not want him, she can choose anyone else. He hears merry tales and smiles not. Merry tales means happy stories. He listens to happy stories, but that also doesn't make him smile. I fear he will prove the weeping philosopher when he grows old. And Portia fears that he will prove, that he will become like the weeping philosopher. Now here weeping means sad. So this sad philosopher is referred to Heraclitus, a Greek philosopher of Ephesus. And he went to live all alone in the mountains because he was dismayed. He was not at all happy with the stupidity of human beings. So he was all the time sad and living in the mountains. So here Portia also says that the Count Palatine, he was also so sad that he will become like a sad philosopher when he grows old, being so full of unmannerly sadness in his youth. Unmannerly means unpleasant. So he was so full of unpleasant sadness in his youth when he was young. So it means that he will become even more sad when he became old. I had rather be married to a death's head with a bone in his mouth than to either of these. And Portia says that she would rather marry a death's head. Death's head means a skull with a bone in his mouth, rather than either of these. Than either of these means either the Prince of Naples or the County Palatine. She would not like to marry these two people. She would rather marry a skull. God defend me from these two. And then she prays to God to defend me, that is to protect and save her from these two people, from these two suitors. Nerissa, how say you by the French Lord Monsieur Le Bon? Now here Nerissa says what Portia thought of, what Portia thinks of the French Lord Monsieur Le Bon. Monsieur Le Bon means, it is referred to, Monsieur means sir, and it is referred to French man. Le Bon, the good, sir, the good. Portia, God made him and therefore let him pass for a man. So Portia here says that as God has made him him, so she should consider him to be a man. In truth, I know it is a sin to be a mocker. And she knows that in truth, in reality, It is a sin to be a mocker, means to laugh at others. But he, why he hath a horse better than the Neapolitans? But Portia says that why does she laugh thinking about him? Because he hath a horse better than the Neapolitans, means he used to talk about his horse more than the prince of Neapolitan. A better bad habit of frowning than the Count Palatine. And he frowned even more than the Count Palatine. So he was more than the Prince of Naples and the Count Palatine. He is every man in no man. He is every man means that he had the qualities of many men in him, in no man. But he himself did not have any personality of his own. If a throstle sings, he falls straight a capering. And he was of such strange behavior that if a throstle is thrush, a bird. So when he heard a thrush singing, he himself start a capering, means he started jumping about. He was so strange. He will fence with his own shadow, and at the same time he was so strange that he will fence with his own shadow. Fence means he will take out his sword and fight with his own shadow. If I should marry him, I should marry 20 husbands. And Portia says that if she married him, then it would be like marrying 20 husbands, because he had the qualities of so many men in him. If he would despise me, I would forgive him. Despise means hate. And Portia here says that if the French lord despise, hates her, then she will not at all feel bad and will forgive him, because it would be nice for her only, because she did not like him, and it didn't matter if he hated her. For if he love me to madness, I shall never requite him. The meaning of requite is return his love. So Portia says that it would be better that he hates her, then she will easily forgive him. But if he loves her to madness, then she shall never be able to return his love. So here she does not like the French. By her talk, by her opinions, we come to know that she does not like the French lord also. So this much for today, children. Revise this much. Go through what I have explained. And note down the meanings also.